Hey there, I am Izzy Noodles. Welcome back to Marshlands. This level is quite long and it's also kind of confusing and not very linear, but I will do my best to make it make sense. There will be a lot of explaining at certain moments, but right now let me just get out of this air duct. So I took the back way in at the end of level one. So we end up in the air duct, and I always have practiced that way to make sure I can show that way to do things if you don't enter through the front door. But I'm pretty certain if you do enter through the front door, you don't set off the alarms, you will actually start the level right here in front of the door. So very clever. But anyway, come on through. So we can see it says Bay X above the door. And I'm firstly taking a right. We will have a dog spawn behind us. Okay, I got it. So it didn't actually make a noise when it went down. I didn't realize it was dead. I kept shooting. But over in this corner, we have a switch and a button. So go ahead and interact with both of those. So we can see a gate has opened. This is in an air duct that I'm about to enter into. That's actually a secret, but still very easy to miss. And then this button, that's shown what it's done to, and that is actually the exit to this air duct. Okay, and then right here on the ceiling, we can just grab this hatch, open this up, and enter into the duct. So this first turn right here, we can see this is where the exit is. We clearly saw this open, but right here, yeah, very easy to miss. This is the secret. And right here is where the door would have been blocking access. So you can go ahead and open this hatch. And then right in the furthest corner of the room, we've got some Uzis with some ammo. Okay, and then just head back out and exit the duct. Oop. Okay, so in this room, you can visit this room a few times. On this very first visit, there should not be a guard here. I feel like one time there was a guard here with a gun. I don't think there should be. There's not usually, but either way, there shouldn't, and all we've come for is this security pass. Let me just double check because I always forget what these cards are. Yes, it is. For some reason, the names of these just don't compute. Also, I would like to point out this hatch on the floor. This is actually a ceiling hatch, so it can only be opened from below. But the security pass is all we need, so we can head back out again. And then head in this opposite direction. So right here, there is a pit of barbed wire, so do be careful. Just grab this edge and shimmy over to the ladder. Sometimes she doesn't like to shimmy, and I don't know why, but use that space, the hallway, just to run around, jump, shoot, roll, I don't know. Use the controls a little bit, and hopefully she will then shimmy over to this ladder. But at the top, let go and grab real quick, and then use the crawl button to get into the gap. So yeah, I've tried to make sure I'm not gonna do too much at once in this level, which can make it seem like there's a lot of backtracking. I tried to do that to make sure it is understandable, because whether it's for your own help, if you are stuck on the level yourself, I like for it to make sense, or if you're watching for entertainment purposes, then of course a bit more explaining is needed to be done because you don't know what's going on. But right here is where I'm using the security pass. I won't use it just yet. There's a few things I want to set up first. And this mess hall slash canteen, however you'd like to refer to it, is the main hub. We'll be back and forth here a few times. So the first door over to my left, that can only be opened from the other side. The door over in the corner can be opened. We'll be heading in there in just a moment. The door to my right needs a key. And there is this ramp that goes all the way around and leads to that door at the top. and that will open as we approach. So there's a few things we can do straight away. So this room is optional, so we will enter this room later from a different doorway, but I'm choosing to come into here now to kill the enemies because they spawn on the tile right on the other side of the door. So if you're opening the door from the other side, you are spending longer on that tile space in a vulnerable position. So I do prefer just to get them out of the way now. So there is a guard with a gun and his dog. Oh, he's dead. Okay, cool. He died really quick. So you can sometimes use that block to your advantage only from the dog, but yeah, it's hard when it's pushing you. But the guy does drop some shotgun shells, and in this room there's a lot of doors going on, so this is the door that we will be entering later, entering through. There's a door ahead, and there's two toilet cubicles here. There is just one item in this one, so you can grab that while we're here. And then exit out. So this room entering now was optional. But firstly, we do need to head up this ramp to the door at the end. This is not optional. And this door right here, this always opens. It is just a dead end. There's nothing there. That door at the end does not open. It's actually a walkway in the water, so you can go and observe the fishes if you like. Up to you. So just approach this door. I am gonna just quickly roll and escape. You may have noticed I did select my pistols. Okay, and plenty of chance to kill that guy before he gets too close. So he does not drop an item. And I am firstly taking a left, so this is the main thing we need to do right now. Just push this, like, computer console, however it is described, off of this trapdoor. Not obvious that this is going to be movable. Oh, I'm trying to grab it again. Don't do that. Just hop on down, and there is a switch. So we can see that's turned off some flames in a kitchen area. We will be heading there very shortly. So that's the setup that I needed to do before going and using the security pass. And I will just be pointing out, because this is a very confusing level, there's a lot of back and forth. So through this doorway we can see two filing cabinets. We cannot open this manually. We'll have to find a button slash switch later on, and we can just see inside. There is a yellow security key, so that's going to be an important item. Also, a ladder straight opposite too, but of course that is not for yet. So now I've turned off the flames, I can head to that location. So as I've said, we're gonna go and use the security pass. So inside we can shoot a dog that doesn't come through this doorway, so that's very handy. And there is a mercenary with a gun, so don't get too close. You're kind of okay over here. So he can shoot you, but most of the time he remains bumbling about, running back and forth like so. So try not to get too close. And he'll not quite see you there. Also, there is a door here that can be opened manually, not much point because we have this door here anyway. And there is a gate we will be opening right there later on. So now locate where the mercenary died. He drops some Uzi clips and head up into this vent. Okay, right here down this hole, this is where I turned off the flames to lead us into a kitchen area. And you can't do a fake grab to try and avoid the flames because of this column. They've made it so you cannot do that. before dropping down, I will set up for something else while I'm here. I just feel I may as well. So some things I've not done that on purpose, but other things I feel, yeah, I will do that while I'm here. So basically we have this button right here. This is timed, it's very snug. It's gonna open the gate right up above and we'll need to climb the rope and not fall. I prefer the half tile jump once pushing the button. Do a roll, do the half tile jump, but if not, you can just quickly sidestep and roll because the button does take room away from trying to do the full tile jump. So when you're ready, take a deep breath. I realized I am taking a deep breath already. Okay, so pretty snug, push the button, half tile jump. That was not what we call a half tile jump, Lara. Okay, clearly my jump has just broken. It does that from time to time. So go ahead and do a normal standing jump and then it should work. There we go. And then one, two, three shuffles up, turn a bit, hop back so you land right on the edge here and then jump on over and enter here. So this is a snug jump and then use this switch. We can see that's open a familiar door, but that's actually going to be for quite a bit later, as I've already said. So it just felt like while I'm here, there's no point backtracking all the way back to this spot. Sometimes, yes, I will backtrack, but if there's no point, I'll just do it while I'm here. Also, always forget this, there is a secret to grab. So back up to here, and I'm just going to shoot that. Also, just gonna grab these Desert Eagle clips. Try and hop back, not always successful. Mostly, but not always. And this is a very tough jump to do. So you can do both a running jump and a half tile jump over the railing and curve around and grab that ledge. I do personally find the half tile is easier. I know it's not always too easy to do. But standing right in this corner, you kind of want Lara's ear to be touching the wall as you hold the look button. This is not 100% accurate, this is just kind of a bit of a try and help you out. This is really tough. Yeah, I never do it in one go. That was close though. There we go. So we have a large med pack and a shotgun. Awesome stuff. So now I can head down into the kitchen. So here we go, just come all the way through, and on this table is what's called a tunnel's key. There is more to do in the kitchen, but I'm going to come back and explain that at the time. So you can do it now, I'm just going to choose not to. So push this button, this leads back out to the mess hall, and I can use the tunnel's key. So it's trying to explain the area, but it's more like passages and corridors. So it seems mazy to begin with, but you soon get the hang of it. So shoot that panel out, come on through, and ahead of me is a T-junction. There is an armed guard on either side, so just pick a side and go straight down, so you're not going to be near both of them. Okay, one down, and then just try and shoot the next one. Okay, and they both drop Uzi clips. And now to explain this section just a little bit. So there is this gate here, and there is a button at the end right here. And I'll come down this way. There is a ladder just to my right with a closed trapdoor at the top. There is this shootable panel with another gate and another button right here. So these buttons are both timed. We have a double timed run to be doing. So starting over here, let's begin. So I can't really explain as I'm running, I'm just gonna have to go for it. So most of the time I do get rid of the camera angles because it saves time. So push the button, got rid of that camera, but run through here, careful of the slopes, and then straight over here. This was blocked off by another gate. But there is nowhere else to go here, so you can only come through here. Shoot this. Okay. And come this way. There's not much down here. So to my right, there's another shootable panel, but I will just wait here for a moment. Shoot two dogs, and there will be an armed guard as well. So he drops some grenades. And I am just quickly coming around the corner for a large med pack. So now back to the shootable panel that I pointed out. So go ahead, shoot this, and the next one, and the next one. But inside this room, do not go without this key card. So which one is this? Control room pass. And then we can approach this gate and it will open for us. This is back where we began the two-buttoned timed sequence. And we're not completely done down in the tunnels. There is still this trapdoor to open up, but we can't do that from down here. So for now, let's leave. So that is something we need to work on. I am going to take an optional detour just to get some Uzi clips. We can come this way. This door will open as we approach. So he did get some shots off on me as the door was opening, but as you can see, we are actually back where we picked up the security pass. This guy is here now and we can pick up his Uzi clips. So this is optional. You might not want to take the damage. It's up to you. It didn't really take too much damage. But here we go, back to the mess hall. And now I'm gonna do the additional stuff in the kitchen. So this is kind of why you could just do it before entering the tunnels. I didn't do much, but I'd rather explain some things as we go along. So right at the back here, we can shoot that. We push the button, we don't shoot the buttons. We did last time though. Okay, shoot the panel. And then head up into here. Yeah, I kind of don't want to be opening too many doors in advance because then it gets a little too confusing. So I've really had to think about the order in which I play this level. So right here we have another lever. This part is still kind of optional, but I believe it is, but we're going to do this sequence anyway. So we need to turn off the flame and we need a movable block. There's a lot of blocks here, but none of them are movable. This block right here, however, is movable, but we cannot get to it from up there. Approach this door and it will open. And we are back in a familiar spot. This is where we killed the first guard and his dog, so they won't be here if you didn't kill them the first time. It's only once you approach the door, start opening this door, that they will spawn. And we can see we did already open up this doorway as well. And there is a door for way later on right here. So this is kind of why I don't want to do too much, because we're not moving on yet and that just makes it confusing to go through that door. But there's a switch just here and that gives us the block. And also while I'm here, I'm pushing the button. It's kind of like this button is the main thing I'm doing right now. We've opened up access to the yellow security key. But I'm doing the block puzzle while I'm here. We will see what this achieves once we've accomplished it, of course. Or at least I'm quite certain I don't really need to do this yet. I forget. It's really been hard to find a good order to do this level in. Okay, the flame is off, so we can pull the lever. Okay, so that's opened up the door that I said is for much later. So considering we're gonna be right here anyway, I guess I didn't have to do the block puzzle. But this door is right here. So yeah, much, much later. But it's done. I did that while I was there. So now what I'm doing, I'm going to go and get the yellow security key. Yeah, to be fair, that could have waited because it is right near the door. I wasn't going to be backtracking too far to get that door open. But of course, I had to go that way to open up access to the yellow security key. So here we go. And next from here, I can climb this ladder now. And right here, I can use the control room pass. Come inside, we have this button right next to this door. And it's not opened the door. Hands up if you thought it was going to open the door. I was so annoyed when I first played. Yeah, so basically, right down there, a hatch is opened, and if we see, we can just make out there's a ladder. So that's the hatch down in the tunnels. We're gonna head straight down there. Okay, here we go. So kind of annoying that sometimes you do have to remember, like, oh, where was that? It's not a big area, but you're definitely going to and fro quite a lot. So I did point out this gate close to the beginning of the level. So I'm heading straight to that location. Okay, so right here where we used the first key card. Okay, and hop straight down here. Shoot this panel, I'll shoot that one in just a moment. I'm gonna point out there is this very obvious underwater lever just here, so this implies we will be flooding this area. And while I'm here, you will be beneficial to open up the ceiling hatch. This is the room where there was the guard the second time round that dropped the Uzi clips. So I don't necessarily need to go back up there, but once this area is flooded, this will be used as a chance to get some air. So very handy. If you miss the chance right now while we're in here, the chance is gone. Right here is a switch. If I continue in that direction, it will be closed off. It is a dead end. Oh, look, that door's open now. Where was that again? Okay. So we are heading straight to that spot. You don't have to climb up here right now. You can just enter or exit back out the way we entered. I don't think it makes a difference because they'll both lead us to the mess hall. And we want to go up the ramp. So yeah, it probably makes no difference which way you decide to exit out. Okay, right here, this is where we picked up the yellow security key, and so then up this ladder. This is where we used the key card. And in we come. Just gonna draw a specific weapon. Okay, so he doesn't drop anything, but in this room we can use this switch. So there's the dead-end walkway that I mentioned previously, and there's the fish you could see, but you could not see that the blue security key just there. So that door will still be closed, but we have flooded that section now. Okay, so we can head straight there. Okay, when's the last time I saved my game? Kind of just forgot to save. That's not like me. Okay, so now we'll need to open up that door that I pointed out, so this underwater lever will do that. And you may want to go back and get some air. So if you did not yet open this hatch, it is obviously too late. But the run, the timed swim sequence, it's not timed, but of course you're limited with your breath. It can be done, but it's very tight. And this is where the fishies are gonna destroy you. Say goodbye to your health. Oh, that was good, that was good. Okay, grab this, and I find it more beneficial not to roll because sometimes she leaves this tile space. You are safe on this tile space, but when you're not ready to leave, they'll just chomp onto you, you know. That was very good today. Usually I'm at like 5% health. Not so good, especially when we still have a bunch of gunmen to kill. And there we go. So we have picked up two security keys. Again, I guess it doesn't really matter which way you decide to exit because we are heading back to the mess hall. So we are actually completely done in this area. Now, so the last thing to do would be to do the put the block on the fiery tile, if you didn't already choose to do that. So we are exiting out and we will not be coming back to this area. So here we go. Just pick a weapon as well. I went the wrong way in the inventory. There we go. So you're still okay if you're blinking on your health and you want to do nomads. So usually 3 shots for that guy, sometimes it's 4. Wait for the dog to get close to give it a one-shot kill. And what we're doing next is not obvious. So I'm gonna climb up to here. And there is this satellite dish that can be moved. So I'm making my way over to there. And careful as you try and climb up here. This is a slope, but there's low ceiling. will stop you climbing. Okay, and careful jumping off the slope as well, because at the bottom is some barbed wire. So just push this all the way to the end. Okay, and that's shown us a room, so that is just right at the back of this area, through this doorway. And it is a little misleading, because if you didn't realise you have to move the satellite and you come into here first and push the button, it shows you the satellite, so that's a nice hint that you need to push the button. But then it comes and shows you the button, so it's nice, but it still doesn't make too much sense, really. I guess you figure it out, but the button doesn't do anything the first time you push it, is what I need to emphasise here. And the button opened a door that was blocking off this section. Hop on down, and here we go. Here is where we're using the two security keys. Awesome stuff. Now we have kind of this quadrangle. It goes around, and so we're going to go in a anti-clockwise direction. So this is the only way we can come so far. Enter through and approach this elevator. Push the button, and that will send us down to the floor below. So exit on out. Going to equip another weapon. Okay, so this guy drops an important item. This one is control room pass, and while we're here we'll need to push this button. So that's opened the door to the next section. And there's like aliens and stuff. Of course there is. It's not Area 51, but there's aliens. You may have already noticed when we picked up the blue security key as well. What's with that? But anyway, now let's head back up. Okay, here we are. So, as I've said, continuing in an anti-clockwise direction. So this is the door I opened by pushing the button. I'm not going to go straight ahead just yet. I am going to come through here. And pushing this button, we'll see what that does. There we go, so that's opened that door. And also, pointing out while we're here, there is this machine which is a receptacle. We will need to place an item here. But now I'm heading back to the quadrangle, and I'm heading round again. So here we go, there was a door here, we watched it open from there. And this is a very complicated jump we're going to be making. So obviously we're going to hit the slopes and grab that one, and then we'll need to sort of climb up that sloped section so that we can flip back to this high ledge above. But there is just a slight like pixel out to make the jump across, so you will need to slide just a little bit on this slope before jumping back. It is kind of annoying. You'll have to probably take a few attempts to do that. Okay, so just shimmy over. I don't think you want to be all the way to the end. You don't really need to be anyway. So just as long as you are on this second tile space. Okay, climb on up and just... Oh, I missed. Hang on. I didn't jump in time. I slid too much. Yeah, this is tough. Okay, there we go. That took a few attempts. There was just the last time I practiced. I thought I got this down now. I did it on the first go, but no, not that time. Oh, but anyway, we have another pass. So a security pass is the one we've just picked up. Return back. So I'm going to go back to, oh my god, I forget where I'm going. The elevator? So this is where I entered the section. Okay, so heading into this first room, we're going to use the elevator again. Because we want to actually activate or open up a second elevator to get us to a new area. So I do believe this time I'm going this way. I've forgotten everything, but yes, I am correct. Here we go. So this is where we're using the security pass, which is the one I've just picked up. Go on in. And we have this kind of canteen-y room, this like break room. And there is a power cell just sitting right on the table here. So someone went to lunch and forgot to pick that up. And there's fishies. And there is a door ahead over there. We can open that, but there is nothing inside. But now we have that, we can head back on out. And again, we're going to be using the elevator. So here we are, back up to the quadrangle. And I'm going to be using the power cell. So this is to be used right over here. So the second elevator has now opened up, and that is this way. As we approach, we can see, oh, but there's no car. Dang it. So we'll have to do this the hard way. So jump on over to this chain, and firstly I'm heading upwards to grab a secret. So it's actually a pretty long chain, there's a long way to go. Especially with this slow climbing. So the camera angle will kind of zoom right in as we're in this enclosed space, but once it backs off again, you do have the space to hop off the chain. There we go. And we have some more Uzis. So now we can just head straight down to the bottom. Okay. So being very careful because it's still a pretty long drop. So basically we came from the opening above and we just want to get to this floor below. So carefully, standing jump, she was angled quite a lot. I thought she was gonna miss that. I got lucky, and just equipping my shotgun because there is this dog and not really anywhere to run around to. Here we go. So we are using the control room pass right here, if I can actually line up with this. And we're gonna do a timed run now. We're heading into that way during the run. Okay, right here is the button. I will just get rid of the camera angle because it's not too tough to do, but of course, tight enough, like all the runs in this game. Oh. So straight across. Through to here, I might not make the jump. So this door right here opened. Ooh! Close. Yeah, I ran into the wall. I would have made it if I hadn't. So just to point out, there's a lot of recognizable music in this entire level set. I did do a private upload to see what would be affected, just involving a few recognizable tracks, and they're all safe. So hopefully it will not change its mind. So they acknowledge this is copyrighted music, but you've not got a block. But we are very close to ending the level now. We're about to grab that treasure map. So down in the water, that's trying to show you there's something down there, but it's not very clear. Okay, so there are 5 mercenaries in this room. If you want to do the no meta challenge and your health is really bad, it can still be done. Hopefully you have 8 Desert Eagle bullets, at least. So, yes, grabbing the Desert Eagle first. Shoot that guy, and then I'm coming back up the ramp to shoot this guy up on this catwalk. He shot me, that's not fair. Swapping to my pistols because there is a guy down here that's a little further away. Oh, he's moved. He's supposed to be way ahead and coming towards me. Here he is. What are you doing, bruv? Okay, plenty of space to have the chance to use your pistols and save some ammo. There is another guy who sometimes he's not yet active. I don't know what activates him, but he is not active. Hopefully you also have your laser sight as well, because this is a big help for dealing with this guy. 2 shots and he's down, and actually I shouldn't have jumped over the railing yet, because this very first guy does drop some Uzi clips. Hopefully I'm not messing up the final guy, but I have enough ammo that it doesn't matter. So while you're here, it's Uzis themselves, my mistake, I said clips. But the final guy is just in this room. Down he goes. So you're pretty home free now. So don't just hop straight into the water, because there are these 2 fish, so just take the time to deal with them in a safe environment. There we go, I'm gonna chill up here while they just stay there. Okay. Just double check. Yep, they're dead. So there's a few rooms round and about here. They're not too obvious because it's quite a large room with lots of the, you know, rocky sections and the catwalks. But one of them is the final room that has the treasure map. So just hopping into the water, there is this gap here, weird alien in this, I don't know, this is like a sunken ship? I don't know what this is supposed to imply. Kind of like, makes me think of Thor, where his hammer's contained around the base from the Marvel films. But anyway, I've just opened 2 trap doors, so now I can start climbing upwards. So there's one over here and one on the opposite side of the room. And right over there is actually the exit, but as I've said, we still have a few things to do before we can manage to open up the door. So we're nearly there though. What we do need to do is hop over to here to climb even higher. So just grab the monkey bars, make your way along. And there is a rope, so do be careful lining yourself up because there's kind of a small ceiling space. So running jump over to that. I'll just reload. Thank goodness I saved it there. I hate climbing. There we go. And so this is kind of a tricky rope because you don't want too much momentum in the slightest. So there we go, just try and land on the other side of the railings, and there's two ways to get across where we need to go. So the easiest is to do a half tile jump over to the flatter section over there, or you can jump over to there. Right now I guess it doesn't really matter because we're actually heading in that direction anyway, so I will just probably do the full jump over to here. So tricky to see which rocks you can stand on at times, so it's not a bad shout to sometimes walk. Ooh, that was snug, nearly didn't make that landing. Okay, there is this button here. So that's not open to the exit, but we're close, very close. We're gonna get the treasure. We're very close to the exciting parts of the games. I don't usually enjoy these like compound levels so much, but it's the premise of we are getting a treasure map. That's the exciting bit. We're gonna go out to sea and grab some buried treasure. So here is the second hatch that we opened. Very convenient because the door that we opened with the button is right here. So now just press this button. That has opened the exits. So you don't need to drop all the way down to climb back up again because we're already on the catwalk. But again, we do need to make the same jumps to climb on up. Okay, another very scary jump. But now, just try your best to line up just here. It's not so easy. You'll need to be on the lower part, so I didn't really want to step up just as she did like that. And we're just heading straight ahead, so it is kind of a sloped tile, like diagonal sloped, so this closer part is safe to stand on. We go. Actually, the whole I thought the whole thing was for a moment, but no, I was correct the first time. And then easy jump up to here and then over the railing. And just to explain, this door will never open. You can't go that way. And if you're not so good with the half tile jump and you want to jump over to this way with the full jump. That's fine, it is a bit trickier to get up to here, but it can be done. You'll just need to try it and, you know, find the best spot for yourself. It can be done. But when you're ready to end the level, come on through. Okay, so apologies, I've decided to end on a freeze frame here before entering the room because I forgot there's just somewhat of a cutscene. It's only like 5 seconds, but it's nice to see it as we enter into a level. So I will end here for today, and then next time we will start up with that little viewing of the flyby. It's nothing exciting, but I wanted to save it. So I hope to see you there. Take it easy.